Okay, so don't get upset with me and scroll on by for talking about Christmas in June, but I wanted to talk a bit about the Christmas ornaments that we make and showcase this one that we just made. Last year, the Christmas and holiday decoration market globally was valued at $7 billion. That is billion with a B, everyone. And quite frankly, it's a market that in our niche of woodworking, we couldn't afford to not be part of. Now, granted, that number includes everything from lights and ornaments to the cheap little trinkets everyone has around their house, like the candy cane holders and the Santa toilet seat covers. But it's a huge market. I mean, just speaking personally, between my mother and mother-in-law, I bet they have spent more money on Christmas decorations than they would care to share publicly. So if you want to poo-poo on the makers that try to crack into this market, that's your right. But I just wanted to provide a bit of perspective and context to the folks that look down on the makers that do it. The money is there. But what I wanted to do was create a holiday decoration that covered the three B's. I wanted it to be big, I wanted it to be bold, and I wanted it to be beautiful. But I also wanted it to be able to be personalized if that's what the client wanted. And I wanted it to be a truly one-of-a-kind decoration that families could look at in awe every year. I did do one thing incredibly stupid, though, when I decided to share it. The timing when I first released the videos and pictures of the ornaments I made last year was not great. The first two I made, I did for Christmas presents for my mom and mother-in-law. I even gave it to them around Thanksgiving so that they could display it in their home. I kept all mention of it on our social media pages quiet, because call me a traditionalist, but I wanted them to be surprised by the gift. And to both their credit, at their age, they are both kind of savvy with social media, so I kept it quiet. Well, when I released the pictures and the videos, it blew up in my face. I was already bogged down with Christmas orders, so much so that I had to quit taking personalized orders that I could guarantee by Christmas Day. And my email and phone were blowing up, wanting these ornaments, and I wasn't ready for it. I missed out on quite a few orders by not being ready to meet the demand, but in hindsight, I keep asking myself, how could I have known? For sure, waiting that long wasn't smart, but flipping the situation around, if I had made 20 or 30 of them and none of them moved, I would probably be in a worse off sitting on a bunch of inventory. So this year, my planning is going to be a bit better. More early advertising, hence this video in June, and I plan on have some ready to go with everything but the personalization left to do. These ornaments take some time to make, and I'm just a one-man shop that tries to maintain some level of balance between work and family. And believe it or not, spending time with my family during the holidays is very important. Well, that's it for this one. If you could, please leave us a comment and share or repost this video. It really helps, and it takes no time at all to do. I doubt many of the people will make it to the end of this video, but if you do, comment what your favorite holiday movie is, and you will be entered into a raffle to get $150 of credit with our shop. Entries will be closed on Saturday, August 31st, and the drawing will take place either on Sunday, September 1st, or during my regular working hours on Monday, September 2nd. Thanks everyone for watching, and we will see you on the next one.